In this video, we present a brief introduction to logic gates, covering the really basic ideas that you'll see in a logic design course, whether you take it in computer science or computer engineering, and a little bit of an introduction to digital electronics. So in logic gates, we use binary arithmetic, because they're all based on the fact that transistors can work as switches. So if they work as a switch, then the output is either high, somewhere around the voltage that powers the transistor, or low, somewhere around zero. By getting it to switch back and forth between high and low, we get it to represent the binary number one or zero. So we have to review very briefly binary arithmetic, and then talk about logic gates, some of the basic ones that digital logic is built around. And then we'll also talk briefly about the fact that you can basically build any gate by combining either what are called NAND gates or NOR gates. The picture shown here sort of pictorially represents the fact that the world of electronic logic gates is a world of ones and zeros. This comes from a website where there's a lot of digital electronic projects for electronics engineering students. And that's another source of projects for this course or for other courses that you could take a look at. Okay, reviewing briefly binary numbers versus the decimal numbers that we're used to. The only difference between binary numbers and decimal numbers is that in decimal numbers, each of the digits represents a power of 10. So we have the 10 to the 0 power digit, we have the 10 to the 1 power. So the 10 to the 0 power is 1, the 10 to the 1 power is 10, 10 to the 2 power is 100, and so forth. In the case of powers of 2, the first digit represents 2 to the 0, which is 1. The second one, which is 2 to the 1, which is 2, and so forth. So you have 1, 2, 2 squared, 2 cubed, 2 to the 4th, and so forth. All right, so if we're going to convert back and forth between binary numbers and decimal numbers, all you really have to do is to look at each digit. You know, okay, so with this digit over here, that's worth 128. Since this is 0, this is 0, and this is 0, it wouldn't matter what the basis was for those, we'd end up with just zeros. This one represents 16, this one represents 8, this one's 2, this one's 1. When you add those all up, you get 155. So the way we represent 155, shown here, that we're usually writing decimally, it ends up as 1001101 to the base of 2. All right, I recommend that you take a look at almost anywhere on the online to find conversion calculators between binary and decimal. You'll also find that they involve conversion to what's called hexadecimal, but in here we're only really going to actually care about binary and decimal. And so take a look at those and see if you can figure out how to simply convert from one to the other. On a test, you won't have access to the binary calculator. So again, use the binary calculator as a way of checking your answers rather than actually generating them in the first place. So that's a very quick review of binary numbers, something most of you have seen in high school. And if you're still confused, then just take a look at the Wikipedia entry or almost any other entry online where there's a quick introduction to binary numbers. Logic gates. Okay, so in a logical system that we're trying to make decisions, we will typically have some kind of a device, which is called a gate, and we do some kind of operation. The simplest one is actually shown here in the upper right, which is a so-called NOT gate. And I show that for two reasons. One is that whenever you have a gate that actually has this little circle on the end, that actually means to negate the operation of the original gate. In this case, there is no operation since there's just one input, so it just negates the input. And this, in fact, is something you can build with a single transistor. So whenever the input is high, remember the transistor would turn on and the output would go low because the collector would be basically 0 volts from the emitter. All right, so when the input is high, the output is low, and this kind of a table of numbers here is a truth table. So the transistor, if its input is low, the output is high, which is here and here. If the input is high, the output is low. And so that's also called an inverter in addition to a NOT gate. Second type of gate that we work with is something called an OR gate. And a third type is an AND gate. And these actually represent things like addition and multiplication. Okay, so in the case of what is called Boolean algebra, you write the OR gate as looks like a summation, and an AND gate looks like a product. And those are intuitively very similar. Okay, so if in an OR gate, if both inputs are low, then the output remains low. If either of the inputs are high, then the output goes high. So 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 1. There's also a remainder in effect, but if you have anything in a high state, then the output will be in a high state. So in the case of the OR gate, the truth table tells us that if both inputs are low, you get a 0, otherwise you always get a 1. In the case of the AND gate, both inputs have to be high for the output to be high. So both inputs are high, the output is high. You can see in all cases we have two inputs here except for the inverter in the upper right. So here 0, 0 gives 0, 0, 1 gives 0, 1, 0 gives 0. It's only when they're both high. Now, this gate and this gate have the little circle or triangle or diamond shape thing at the end, which is basically just taking the shape that was there before. So if you have the and you put a little circle here, then you get what's called a NAND gate. And all that means is it takes the value that it would ordinarily take and negates it, in effect, putting a NOT gate after the original gate. Okay, so 0, 0 would normally give us 0 with an AND gate, but now we're taking the 1, I'm sorry, taking 0 and getting 1, which is up here in the inverter. So basically the entire truth table, just pause for a moment here. Okay, so I've erased everything. So we have the entire truth table for the AND, which goes 0, 0, 0, 1, and we just negate everything. We just flip it to the other state, and it becomes 1, 1, 1, 0. Same thing happens between the OR and the NOR gate. Right, so in the upper right-hand corner, we have the inverter or NOT gate. Then we have the AND gate and NAND gate and OR gate and NOR gate. The last thing that we have here is actually called what's called the exclusive OR gate. And this has a very interesting truth table. It says that if the two states are identical, then the output is low. If the two states are different, then the output is high. And you may or may not immediately realize by looking at this that this is the same kind of a switch arrangement as exists in what are called by some people two-way or three-way switches. That is, if you, for example, you have a stairway in your house and there's a switch at the top of the stairs and a switch at the bottom of the stairs. And so that no matter what state that they're in, if you flip the switch, it'll change state. So if the lights are on and the switches are in some state and you flip one switch, the light will go off. If you switch either switch after that, the lights will go back on again. And so exclusive OR is that kind of a gate. There's one more kind of gate that we should actually have on here. It's the exclusive NOR gate, which looks exactly like the exclusive OR, except has a little circle here, and then everything reverses. We'll see that again in a second. So those are logic gates. You want to make a decision. You've got two inputs, and you want to compare them in some way or other. If you want to make a decision based on the fact that they're both high, Then you would use an AND gate if you want to make a decision based on the fact that as long as one is high, then you would use an OR gate and so forth. All right, so there's a tool that's very simple to use for this purpose, and it's called Logic Lab. There's actually a lot of these different things online. I recently found this and it actually works pretty nicely, so I'm going to switch over so we can use Logic Lab in order to test out how these gates work. And this is something you'll be asked to do in class. Okay, so here's Logic Lab. This is the location online. If we just go down here and we do the examples, it actually fills this in for us. So what we have here is a representation of each of the gates, including actually the exclusive NOR, which I didn't have room for on the other slide. And with the exception of the inverter or NOT gate, every one of them has two inputs. So with the AND gate, you notice these are switches that are in the low state. I raise one high, I raise the other high, the output doesn't change. If I make both of them high, the output changes. In the case of the NAND gate, it should be exactly the opposite. So since it was low for everything except when it was high, you notice that when it's low, both are low, it's on. One is on, the other is on. When they're both on, it goes low. And in the case of the OR gate, what would we expect? We would expect that whenever I turn either one of these things on, I should get, it should go high for me. So high, high, and high. The one state is called high and the zero state is called low. And similarly, we can do this with the other ones. You can play around with this and just get a feeling for what happens as you change the inputs and what happens to the output. If you put them all together in a table, it's called the truth table. So we're back at the slides now. And that's basically it for the basic gates. All right. Next thing we want to notice is that, well, actually, how do we make such gates? And we make the gates out of transistors. And what I'm showing here is a very simple way of making either a NAND gate or a NOR gate using transistors. Now, a question is, which one is the NAND gate and which one is the NOR gate? I should immediately be able to tell that the one at the right over here, that if this transistor turns on, then this voltage goes to ground. If this transistor turns on, then this voltage goes to ground. So this is an OR type operation. And so if either one of these is on, then this goes low. So if this is high, or this is high, if this is high or this is high, then the output, if this one's low and, or this one's low, then this will be high, as long as they're both low. Okay, over here we have an AND type operation, and that is that this transistor, both transistors have to be on for this to go down to ground. Okay, and so this is a very simple way of showing how we can make a NAND gate or a NOR gate. Now let's make sure that these are actually NAND gates. So in the case of a NAND gate, if we go back up here, the NAND gate says that if, as it shows right here, if both are low, we should have, the output should be high, should be as positive as it could be. If both are high, the output should be low. Okay, so if both of these are low, both transistors are off, and the output will be high. If both of these are on, both transistors are on, and the output will be low. So it's, and I could fill in the rest of the truth table from that. So this is definitely the NAND on the left and the NOR on the right. Now, can we make other gates from either of these logic gates? You know, if we can make NAND gates out of transistors, and if we can make all other gates out of NAND gates or all other gates out of NOR gates, then we're all set. We can make any kind of a gate we want. So it turns out, yes, you can actually make basically any kind of gate out of NANDs or any kind of gate out of NORs. If you look online, you'll actually find NAND gate logic, its own Wikipedia entry. And so, for example, here is an OR gate, and here's how you make an OR gate using NAND gates. Okay, to speed things up, I've actually written out the steps I'm going to go through right now. So on the left, here is the NAND gate truth table. So you can see whenever the inputs are zero, both zeros, you get a 1, or 0, 1, you get a 1, or 1, 0, you get a 1. So basically, they're all 1s as long as you have a 0 on the input. If you have two 1s on the input, you get a 0 on the output. Okay, so I've indicated here the same two inputs for A and B. You notice right here, I've labeled the next two points, internal points in the circuit, as C and D. C is just not A, since that's the way you make an inverter. So you notice here is 1, 1, and then 0, 0, which are exactly the opposite. So this one and this one are the opposite of one another. So this is a 1 right there, sorry. And then this one, I'll put two lines there, and then this one. So I accidentally turned the PowerPoint presentation off. So that one, and then this one, are just the opposite of one another. So then we have C and D as the input to the last NAND gate there. So again, if it's both ones over here, it becomes a zero, and then the rest of them are ones, and that's the truth table with this as the input, and this is the output, is the truth table of an OR gate, which is what this is right here. Now, I leave it to you to show that this combination up here gives you an exclusive OR. And then on the next page, we have NOR gate logic, where we've also, again, made an exclusive OR out of NOR gates. And here we've made an AND gate out of NOR gates. Now, the one thing I'll point out here is that you see in the case of both the NAND gate and the NOR gate, an AND gate has the same number of components. The exclusive OR can be made with 4 NAND gates, but it takes 5 NOR gates. So sometimes it's more efficient to use a NOR, and sometimes it's more efficient to use a NAND. But in any case, you can make either out of NANDs. So you can make it using all NOR gates or all NAND gates. Why do we care about this? Because once you've got a well-designed block in your integrated circuit, which is a NAND gate, you just need to combine them together in order to make every other kind of gate that you want to make. Okay, summarizing in a slide where you can't actually see the details here, but this comes from a really excellent book called Practical Electronics for Inventors, which is right here. I recommend it as a book that you may want to consider buying at some time or other. It is only $20. It's slightly less than $20 if you get the paperback version of it. It's slightly more than $20 as the Kindle version. And on this page, which comes from the book, it actually summarized 5 different things here. There's a list of all the gates, which are right here. So we've got an inverter, an AND gate, a NAND gate, an OR gate, a NOR gate, exclusive OR, and then exclusive NOR down here. All right. And then what's next? There's a truth table, which is just shown here, and every one of the truth tables is listed there. Then you can see that I mentioned previously the exclusive OR can be made by the switches at the top and the bottom of your stairs. So there's actually, it turns out to be a switch analogy to everything. So the switch analogy to the AND gate is here, to the NAND gate is here, and so forth. And then you can make them out of transistors, and here's the transistors that shows how you can make them. And in a sense, this is, as it's indicated here, it's an analogy, because this is not exactly the way that we make these things, but you can make them out of these type of transistors. These are actually showing BJTs, but these days almost everything is made out of CMOS. So you have the transistor analogy, and then finally in is the description, is actually what it does. So, very nice, concise page with that type of information. You can find these in other locations, not just this book, but I figured you might like to know about this book in case you'd like to have a textbook that kind of covers a lot of the material that we're covering in this course. All right, so we've covered digital electronics very briefly, logic design very briefly. If you're interested in doing a digital electronic project rather than an analog electronic project, you can just Google digital electronic projects. Here is a website that has many, many kinds of options. This circuit right here is actually kind of neat. This is the integrated circuit here is just a, I think it's a combination of OR gates or NOR gates. I can't remember exactly what it is. I didn't write it down here. Once it's powered and you put some LEDs and resistors on it, and then you put a connector that connects to a coaxial cable, it will tell you whether the cable is good. So it's a simple way of making a coaxial cable tester. So if both the inner conductor and the outer shield are in good shape on the coaxial cable, if you plug them into this kind of setup, then the LEDs will turn on or not, depends upon which one is supposed to turn on in order to show that it's good. So that's this topic, and we will see you in class.